All right, you guys, grab your water because this is gonna be a tough one. Let's start with the warm-up. Feet are hip width parallel, knees are soft, abs are in and up. So your hips are upright, shoulders relaxed. Let your head fall over to the side. Press the opposite hand down. Roll it down and through. Press the opposite hand down, getting the neck stretch. One more time to each side, just working the kinks out of your neck. You hold a lot of tension here, come back through center. Roll your shoulders. 4, 3, 2, 1. Reverse. 4, 3, 2, 1. Inhale your arms all the way up. Press them down. Yep. Feel your shoulder blades go down your back. So this is the calm before the storm. Press, stop at shoulders. Roll through your wrists. Work the kinks out. Press your palms straight down. Lift your right leg up. Roll through your ankle. All right, so the more you pull your stomach in here, the more likely you'll have better balance. Tops of your toes come down. Get through the front side of your shin. So we don't get this stretch a lot. It's a good one, especially if you do a lot of cardio. Change sides. Switch rolling both directions. We're going to be on your feet quite a bit, so this helps, you know, massage out those tendons, ligaments, fronts of your legs. And then ragdoll, roll it down, place your palms flat, and then stretch into the backs of your legs. So just take a regular deep breath here. Roll it up one vertebrae at a time. Shoulders are down. All right, start marching in place. Regular old knees up, abs are in. So it's a standing abdominal crunch if you think of it that way. Add the arms. Pulling arms down as knees go up. Four more. Two, after this next set, you're gonna add a twist, twisting to the right, and change, back and forth. Getting into your obliques from a standing position. Four sets left. Two. Stopping in the center, reach your arms up. Right knee comes out to the side, into your obliques still, now warming up inner and outer thighs and hips. Last one, stopping in the middle, little out and in, pop. Little mini jumping jacks, nothing crazy. Getting your heart rate up. 3, 2, front and back mini lunges, light on your toes. Now put the two together. Out, in, front, back. Out, in, front, back. 3, 4. So jumping is good for building up your bone density. Think like a cat, light on your toes. 2 more. Last one, stopping in the last part of your warm-up. Arms extend up, and then pull your knee in and out. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Second set, same side. Switch it up, reach your arms long, pull it in. 16. Bring your heart rate back down. We're nice and warm. Let's get to work. Keep your purple weights handy. We're gonna come to our mat, coming down into a plank and oblique series. So you always wanna make sure that going up and going down is part of the exercise. Reach your arms up, roll it down. Take a deep breath, bring your heart rate down, walk it out. All right, when you set up your plank here, cross your arms right in front of each other. So it's gonna be an easier transition into the actual side plank series. We have 30 seconds here. So as we're doing this plank, I'm gonna talk about form with safety. So hip bones knit to your rib cage, just like so. You've got a nice long lower back. We have 30 seconds on our clock at home. Be sure to watch yours. Her heels are pressing back, but her weight is shifted forward. That's where the two-way stretch is. So if this series is quite lengthy, if at any point in time you need to take a break, we're just gonna soften your knees down to the mat. Don't belly floss, it's way more energy than you need to expel right now. So hold it here. Let's see, we have 5 more seconds on our clock. 4, 3, 2, now rotate onto your right forearm so you're in a side plank. Once you're here, you have 3 feet position of options. Advanced would be stacked, intermediate would be split, and then beginner would be top foot down. So do what you can at home. We're gonna show different options here. Feet are stacked for me, Stacy's gonna split them up for you. Grab that 2-pound weight, reach it up to the ceiling. Okay, before you do anything, keep your hips up, pulse it up. 5, 4, 3, 2, hold it up on 1. Weight goes behind your head, curl it down, and untwist. Curl it down, untwist. Curl it, and twist. So once again, Stacy's really working through all of these side muscles through her obliques. 1 more, twist it through, stay here. Reach your arm top to the ceiling, good. And then she's gonna pull her elbow to her knee. Extend it out, nice long line. 2, 3, 4. She's still working into her obliques. We're doing all different angles. Last one, come back through center to her forearm plank. So you have a 30 more seconds on the clock, right here. Tailbone slightly tucked again. Top of her head practically touches the other side of the room. If this is your first couple times or you're still a beginner, I would stay and just kind of rest your knees as you need to. If you come all the way down, it's much more effort to come back up. So we have 10 more seconds. Setting yourself up. Holding it here. Keeping those little purple weights handy for 3, 2. As you change sides, come all the way over. Reach your arm up nice and tall. And then add the hip lift. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hand goes behind your head. Curl it down. Uncurl. Curl elbow to hand. Uncurl. Elbow to hand. Untwist. Elbow to hand. Untwist. One more. Elbow to hand. Untwist. Stay. Reach your arm long. Elbow to knee. Tap. Extend. Tap. Extend. Tap. Extend 2 more. Last one. And come back through center. Okay, put your weight down. Come back for a child pose.
Gladly.
All right, once you stretched out there, we're gonna get started with our thigh series. Might as well get the worst part over first.
So this is really where Barre got its nuts and bolts from, this whole thigh series, this ballerina leg, whole long series at the Barre. Bear with us, it's pretty brutal. Starting in second position, basically all that means are your legs are out wide. And when you turn your feet out, even if you have the flexibility to really go out there, it flips your pelvis. So keep it right in line, second and third toe with your knees. So it's about a 45 degree angle. You can rest your outside hand on your hip, and you can actually even face the Barre at home. We're facing you so you can see what's going on, but you can face straight ahead with both hands on the Barre. Otherwise, abs scoop in. So many times when I teach, I see people's bottoms stick out, and that's not what we're doing here. Lower down and up. 8 plane pliés to get you started. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You're gonna hold it down on 8, little presses, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, hold. Now, just your knees press back. So it's a really small movement. Knees press, 4, 5, 6, 7, pause, heel lifts, 1, 2. So Stacy is gonna show the modified throughout. Really, it's just a more limited range of motion. So it doesn't mean she's working any less, you know, more than any of us are. It's just a different range of motion. After this one, hold it up, right where you are. And we're gonna repeat that whole series on your toes. So go all the way up, all the way down. If you have any kind of knee issues, once again, hip issues, you'll reduce your range of motion. 4 more, 3, 2, hold it down, back to the pulses. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, hold, press. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, hold on, 8, heel presses. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, piece of cake, next series. Now, this is technically called third position, as I was taught by the ballerinas. However, we like to call it the model pose because it's most how people pose in pictures. Your heel is gonna come to the inside arch. So we're gonna start with right heel in front of the arch and then left foot turns out. They're both in that, just like first position, but off-centered. So from here, warm up with basic releves. Heels go up and down. 2. So yes, you're gonna feel this in your calves, obviously. This helps prevent cankles. But you wanna really pull up the length of your body. Stomach is in, squeeze your booty. 2 more, it's also the calm before the storm. And then holding it here, plain pliés here. Down and up. 2, 3. So similar to the series we did a minute ago, different leg position and there'll be some different variations throughout. 2 more, hold it down this time. Pulse it, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, hold, little tucks, tuck, release, tuck, release, tuck, release, 4, 3, 2, 1, come all the way back up. You have 2 counts to shimmy down and 2 counts to shimmy up. So I'll turn to the side so you can see what's going on. From here, down, 2, up, 2, down, 2, up, 2, 2 more, 2, up, 2, last, down, down, up, up. Switch out sides real quick. Left foot goes in front, start with 8 releves, lift and lower, 2, 4, 6, hold it up on 8. Now, back to those full range of motion plies. Down and up. 2. So I'm gonna demonstrate on Stacy here. She's going nice and low in her form. Her hips are upright, so she's not over tucking. I see that a lot too, which isn't great for your low back. And her shoulders are nice and relaxed. Now on the next one, hold it halfway, little up and down pulses. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, little tucks, tuck. So once again, just a smaller range of motion, they're both correct. 4, 3, 2, 1, come back up, and 2 down, 2 up. 2, 1, up, 2. Down, 2, up, 2. Down, 2, up, 2. Last, down, down, up, up, and shake it out. Okay, final series here. If your thighs feel like they are bleeding, you're doing it right. Totally normal, it's not, it's safe, don't worry. Now, hug your inner thighs together in closed parallel. Final position here, hug your inner thighs. Really, you know, get the most out of this workout as you can. Starting with releves, lift. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hold it up on 8. All right. Sitting down into that chair again. So have a seat, down and up. 2, squeeze your tush. 3, it should help distract your thighs a little bit. 4 more. 3, 2, hold it down on 1. Now, knees open nice and wide and together. So on this one, you're working inner thighs slowly. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. One more set here. 8. If your thighs are shaking and burning, you're doing it such a good job. 3. If they're not, go lower. 4, 5, 6, 7. Hold it out on 8. Pulse it out. We're almost there. 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, isolated hold, don't go anywhere, 8 seconds, 7 seconds, 6, 5, 4, 3, two, and shake it out. Wow. Awesome job. I know Stacey did the whole series, so she's giving me like, oh my gosh, I can't believe. We really do this, it's terrible. It's terrible punishment. Okay, so before you earn your thigh stretches, we've gotta go knock out some cardio.
For this cardio set, you've got 30 seconds side to side, 30 seconds free throw. So what that means is, for side to side, you have two options. The modified version, Stacey's gonna show reaching down, just not going as low so that you don't compromise any knee safety. And then for the high intensity version, you'll drop all the way down, jump up, side, side. Okay, now for free throws, the full version, high intensity, you'll come all the way down, jump up, same thing back and forth. Modified, any joint or knee or back issues, just come halfway, rise onto your toes, halfway. All right, then you've earned your thigh stretches, so you'll get a breather. Starting in 3, 2, and 1. Just like a little downhill skier, and start punching it out. get those arms nice and heated up, punching it out, shoulders pressed down. You just want to keep your gaze straight ahead and find a little focal point on the floor, and then pulling your shoulders back will help keep you out of your trap muscles and more into your lat muscles. Those are the ones on the sides of your rib cage, better known as back time. Now, same thing, face your palms in. Punch it out. Really pulling those elbows nice and tight to your sides. 8 more. 3, 2, hold it out on 1. Okay, from here, let's slow it down a notch. Pull those elbows all the way back and squeeze, come back down. Pull all the way back, squeeze, come back down. 3 squeeze. When I say squeeze, what that means, pull your shoulder blades together like you could crack a walnut back there. 4 more. 3 more. 2, 1, pause. Let's start the original position, palms facing up, out, pull back. 2, squeeze. 3, squeeze. 4, 5. Last one, and extend it long. Now, from here, your elbows are soft, shoulders back, lift your elbows out, squeeze into your armpits, extend it out, and come back down. Lift up, squeeze in, out, down. Up, squeeze, out, down, up, squeeze, out, down. Working your upper back and also all throughout your arms. This is a multitasking. 3 more, 2 more, make sure you're engaging and not just going through the motions. Hold it here, nice and long. Now just the bend and press part. Bend, press, bend, press. 3, extend, 4, extend, 5, we're gonna go to 8, 6, 7, 8, hold it, last set, little baby press back, press, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, you said I wasn't sneaking shoulder work in, and come back up. Alright, now, keep your ball close by, have the feet smack on top, we're getting into chest and triceps. So, if you sit on top, and actually I'm going to face toward away from things in the room, rolling down into it, getting into your chest. When you lie back here, the only thing that's resting up top are your shoulders and head. Your booty should be nice and lifted. Hamstrings have to work, bottom has to work. So, starting up top, palms face each other. Once you're here, soften the elbows and shoulders close. Open the arms out to the sides and squeeze together. So this is a chest fly. Now, when you come out, you'll notice we're not going below shoulder height. Accent is on the up, two more on the first set, last one, hold it up top, now palms face away from you, and then this is a traditional chest press, so elbows come down, press straight ahead. So these are the two chest moves that we're working with today. We're going to alternate back and forth between the two moves in sets of 8. 6, 7, 8, hold it up top, go back to the fly. Palms face in, elbows soften. Open, squeeze. They just work different angles of your chest muscles. Accents on the up. after this, we have one more of each. So hold it up and palms face each other. Elbows soften, open. Now, this is your last set of each, so really make it count. Squeeze. Squeeze. 4, 5, 6, 7. Hold it up, face the palms away from you. Chest press, 8, 7. So quality over speed here. Don't just go through the motion. This helps with armpit back. Hold it up on one. And carefully roll yourself back to a seated position. Okay, getting into your tricep series. So you see, I'm gonna show you two different angles, but you're sitting on top here, feet are hip width parallel. The more narrow they are, the harder it is, and the wider it is, you know, the easier it gets. So from here, pitch your weight forward, back into that downhill skier. Abs right now, pull your elbows back as far as you can go. Press all the way long for triceps, feel them engage, and then bend. Bend, press. So in some of the other videos that we do 2 pound weights. If we have threes, we're gonna go a little bit slower and not do as many reps. So what that means is you wanna make every rep count. The back of each move should hurt every time. I can drop all weights all together and it will still hurt. 8 more in this position. 7, 6. Things to be mindful of is your stomach in. Are your shoulders back? You don't want to hunch over here. And then the higher those arms go, the more challenging. So we don't want you doing it down here. You're not going to get much out of it. Now, hold it straight. Pulse it. 8, 7, 6 up, 5 up, 4, 3, 2, pause, palms face up, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, hold it as high as you can, squeeze everything for 8 seconds, 7 seconds, 6, 5, 4, let's do one more set of presses, we can do it,
we can do it,
back to the presses, I know, I totally psyched you up, 2, we're gluttons for punishment over here, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8, all right, shake it out. So before we get into the arm stretches, we'll do the cardio set first and stretch it out while we're cooling down from cardio. Place your ball back off to the side, out of your way. Throughout the workout, you'll see about 60 second intervals of cardio. Really push yourself. You'll get a stretching series or a traditional rest period afterwards to bring your heart rate down. The first one is 30 seconds of curtsy kicks. So it's not gonna go as fast as some of the other ones, but you're gonna keep your hands on your hips for stability. For an added challenge, you can always lift your arms up, but for right now, just hips. So the move is, the right foot will step behind, basically it's called a curtsy, but it's really just a side one, and then kick it up nice and high. So this will be moved back and forth. Now, with that said, we're gonna do 30 seconds on each leg. Yes, I want you to go as fast as you can, but balance is your priority, not falling over. All right, so start your clocks at home. We're gonna start here. In, let's see, 3, 2, and 1. Down and up. The whole point of these is to get your heart rate up. Your heart rate should be up. You should be out of breath.
We definitely are.
You're not doing it right. You've got to work harder next time. All right, so let's go back and stretch your arms. Pull your right arm across your chest. Pull from behind the shoulder blade. same right arm is going to reach up, extend backwards. And switch it up, left arm comes across. Left arm comes up. And then finally, reaching behind you, clasp your hands, pull your chest and shoulders open. Today's going to show you the side angle. You're pulling your shoulders back. Also, for an added stretch, you can flip your grip. And that gets deeper into your pec muscles, the chest muscles that we talked about. All right, shake it out. Next up on deck is booty at the bar.
So for your booty set today, I'm going to show on Stacy how you want to set your body up. Both of her forearms, you're going to turn and face the bar, stack on top of each other. So she's not collapsing on top of, you know, her forehead onto her hands, but she has this nice long spine. Her stomach is scooped in, so her lower back is supported. You shouldn't feel any tension here. Now, the big key with this series is that both knees have to stay slightly bent. People get tired and they start to straighten. So keep your knees soft, and then it's totally normal if you feel it on the standing leg as well. So that doesn't mean stop, it means keep going. All right, so starting here, we will change positions so you'll get guided as we go. Abs are in, starting on, I'm gonna demonstrate on the left so that you can see what's going on. Stacy's gonna do the right, outside leg. Starting with plain knees, gonna pull all the way into your nose, and then stretch it long. Pull in, stretch long. Pull in, stretch. Four, really deliberate. Five, press. Six, press. Seven, press. On the eighth one, hold it out there. Pulse it. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, hold. That big toe taps down to the ground and kicks up. Now you'll notice when we're kicking up, we're not going so high that our hips turn out. You only want to kick as much as your booty will engage. Two more, hold it up on one, and then come through center into a bent knee. Fire hydrants here, wide to the side with a bent knee and back together. So I'm just gonna turn and, you know, show you on Stacy, going wide to the side, four, she's still in that right angle, three, everything's still supported, two, holding it up on one, pulse it, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, hold, go halfway down and back up. Halfway and up. Three and up. Four and up. Five, six, seven, eight. Now hold that knee up there. You're going to rotate your whole body. So now I'm leaning on the forearm, in my case, the right forearm, because we're still working left leg, so it's opposite. And then the kick is gonna stay right in line with your hip. So I'm working both obliques as well. You'll feel it definitely in your sides. And the leg goes all the way out, nice and long. Leg long kick down and up to start. Down and up. Lower kick, lower. So you're still gonna bend that standing leg. Nice and soft. Three more, two. Hold it up on one, flex your foot. Now kick your booty and extend. I'm gonna stand down so Stacy has plenty of room. Kick and extend. So what she's working here are these little upper hamstring muscles right behind your bottom. These are the ones that lift up your tush. Very important. Three more, keeping her knee right in line with her hip. Two, last one. Hold it back there. Now point your big toe. So her big toe is practically on her bottom right now. And then little poke backs, like she's trying to touch something behind her. So she's also feeling this in her obliques. Press, 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 press. Four, if you're cramping here, that means you are dehydrated. Hold, pulse it up. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, hold. Now rotation. So she's gonna go knee, heel, and they're little, nothing big. Knee, heel, I'll turn to the side so you can see a different angle. Knee, heel, knee, heel, rotate, 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 Now, after this one, you're gonna go into your figure eight. So that means the knee's gonna do full range of motion all the way around. So this one, it is okay if your hip is opening and turning. You're working through all those little intrinsic muscles all through your upper outer thighs and your tush, lots of tush. Four more, these look really good. Three, two, hold it out on one. We're gonna go back to those long leg kicks all the way down, all the way up, nice and long. When you're kicking here, you want to stretch out of your hip socket. So I'm imagining my big toe can practically touch the other side of the room. Four more, three, two. On this last one, hold it up. Finish strong, baby circles. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Reverse it. Two, three, four, five, six, seven. Hold it, hold it, hold it, and lower. Okay, all right. Cross your the leg that you were just working, so in my case, my left. You're gonna cross over the ankle and just stretch away and hold. Come back through center and change sides. Okay, so Stace, why don't you and I go ahead and switch it out so we even ourselves out, not doing another, I don't wanna make her go through the whole thing on the other side. She might kill me after we're done. All right, so same setup. She's crossed at the forearms and then her knees are slightly bent. So once you're here, abs are still in, of course, right knee is gonna pull all the way in, all the way out. So if you at home are doing left, continue on following Stacy. Press and press and stretch it long. Stretch it long. Three more, squeeze at the back of the move. Two, hold it back on one, pulse it. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, hold. Big toe goes down and up. Once again, the key here is that you're not externally rotating through that hip. So her hips are facing straight down to the ground. She's getting all of this work in her booty. Three more, pointing the big toe away. Hold it up on one, and then bend the knee to come in for fire hydrant. So, knee goes out, together. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, hold it on eight, pulse, two, six, seven, hold, halfway down and up, halfway and up, halfway and up, four, up, five, up, six, up, seven, up, eight, up, and good. Rotate onto that supporting forearm. So the standing leg stays bent. We're also working our obliques here, abs are in. Extend the knee all the way up and extend it out, down and up. Two and up, three. Really getting into these obliques here, so you'll feel sore tomorrow in your sides as well. Six, she's doing a great job of reaching away. Hold it up right where you are. Flex your foot, kick your bottom. One, two, three, four, I'm gonna get out of her way. Five, six, she's doing a great job of really squeezing into her booty. Hold it, point your toe, and then it's really small. So just because she's up against the wall here, yep, we can take a little step forward. It's just a tiny motion, pulse one, two. She's going this way. The big thing is keeping your big toe close if it's more space, so she doesn't even need room back there. Hold it, hold it, hold it, pulse your knee up. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Okay, so with your knee here, and Stace, why don't you go ahead and rotate to face forward and they can see the rotation. So once you're here, the knee goes down, up. So it can just be little to start, nothing crazy, knee, heel, knee, heel, working all of those angles. Two more, one, now going into your figure four stretch, all the way through and around, exactly. Two, working through, think of it as an active massage. I know in class people always, you know, like send me death glares when I say that. Three more, two, great job. Last one, holding it out to the side, extend that leg all the way out, right where you are, still opening, and baby, actually let's do down and ups first. Two, three, four, five, six, seven. This time you're gonna hold it up, baby circles. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, reverse it, two, three, four, five, six, seven, hold it up on eight, hold, 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 and lower down. Okay, take that leg, cross it in front of your ankle, and stretch away so you get the oblique stretch. So obviously at home, if you're just holding on to a loose chair, I would not do this stretch. You wanna make sure you're holding on to a countertop or something that's sturdy. And come back up. Let's move on to some cardio.
Here is your final set of cardio. All right, so as always, there's a low impact variation. If you have any kind of joint, back, hip, knee, any of those kind of issues, please take it down a notch. It's not worth it. You still get your heart rate up and work just as hard as if you're bouncing around. Now, with that said, if you're healthy, please challenge yourself and get your body off the ground. So the moves today are, we're gonna reach right arm up at the punch and change and then down, down. So one more time just to get that in. You go up, up, down, down. So the modification would be you'd obviously take out the jumps and just don't go as low. So this is pretty compromising if you have any issues. Just think he's gonna show you not as going as low. That's the other one. So two up, two down. After 30 seconds, you knees are coming, 30 seconds broken. So, and honestly, if you have any kind of really severe hip pain, then I would just jog in place and skip it all together. But everybody else should find it. Low impact, safe mind, turn to the camera so you can see both. So let's do step towards me and do low impact first. So she'll reach up, step, step, in, stand up, perfect. So no bouncing around. Now the high impact, she'll go down, jump out, jump in, jump up, like a little jumping thing. Pogo stick. Okay, perfect. I don't want to wear you out before we start. So pick your poison. We're gonna watch our clocks at home. Follow along. Set your own timers. Do what you gotta do. Starting in. We're gonna watch our clock in 3, 2, and 1. Reach up. Objective, you know, in our case, our knees are popped up, so it's okay if it doesn't sit nicely. is that your heels are flexed and that your shins match each other. So that's how you're gonna get both of these hips down. So in a perfect world, yes, your knee would be on top of your foot, but we do a lot more. In which case, these outer muscles are tighter. If you're more flexible, you might not get as much out of this stretch. Otherwise, palms come out in front of you, lean your chest forward. So you're really feeling it in both of your hips. Use the whole point of having your foot on your thigh, make sure it's not on your knee or on the inside of your leg, is it's acting like a weight. Take a deep breath, come back up, switch them out. Left foot stacks over your right thigh, like so. Flex your feet again, make sure they're stacked, press it forward.
We have made it to the finish line, you guys, so. Last little spurt, ab series. So let's really, all throughout the workout today, you've worked your lower abs by constantly pulling your abs in, I hope. So now we're gonna turn them up and go from there. Hands are behind your head. We're using a bar because we have it. If you don't, you can certainly rest your feet on your wall at home, on a countertop, same chair you've been using. Feet are in first position. Hands go behind your head. They're stacked so that you don't cut off your circulation. Lower abs are in. Start with basic crunches. Up and down. On the eighth one, hold it and pulse it. Really knitting your belly button in nice and tight and lower back down. Okay, right arm comes across your body. So just like you're peeling off a sticker, reach and lower down. Reach and lower down. Reach. So if you're doing this correctly, you should feel a pinching action happening in your left oblique, as if your hip bone could touch your bottom floating rib. Two more full range of motion. Hold it up, pulse it up. Reach. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Lower back down. All of that on the other side. Left arm goes across. You'll watch my shoulder peel off. And lower down. Peel off, lower. Peel off, lower. Peel, lower. Peel, lower. Peel, lower. Hold it up, pulse it up. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, lower back down. Hands go back behind your head. Now, this time you'll scissor kick your leg. So the leg is gonna kick off, leaving the other one on. Now, unfortunately, you still have to keep your head up. So, head comes up, right leg kicks, and left. Right, left, right, left. Four more sets, three more, two, on this last set, hover your feet away and little kicks. Kick, 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 kick. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Feet go down, give your head a break. The next set requires a little bit of brain power, but we trust you at home to follow along. So head, neck, and shoulders come up. Hold it here. Now your feet hover away from the bar, and unfortunately they stay there. So legs open out about the width of your mat, squeeze together. Now just the right leg floats away. Squeeze together, left, and then we'll start again. So open, close, right, left. Open, right, left. Open, right, left. When you're doing this, you should be looking at your hip bones to make sure that they are not going the other way away from your legs. So your hips and your pelvis stay totally stable. One more set after this. Open, close, right, left. Stay here, little crisscrosses. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Feet go down, head goes down. Okay, take a deep breath. This time head, neck, and shoulders go up and stay up. And right knee pulls in only, and taps, in, and tap, in, end tap staying on the right side. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, switch legs. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, incorporating your lower abs, 2, 1, keep your head up, both knees in and out, 2, and out, 3, and out, 4, tight ball, 5, tight ball, 6, 7, 8, and lower head down. We'll seal it off with some hip lifts. So, arms go down by your sides, ground through your triceps, feet come an inch or so away to 90, flex your feet. Do not send your legs far overhead, you're just gonna go straight up, little hip lifts. 1, 2 up, 3 up, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, last 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, put your feet on the bar, reach your arms all the way overhead, stretch it nice and long. And then swoop around to hug your knees into your chest, give them a good squeeze. That's gonna do it for us today. Hope you guys enjoyed our bar workout and you join us again.